All right, so this video is about The Witch of Blackbird Pond by, if I remember right, her name is Elizabeth Speare. This is another favorite book that I had taught, and it's about a fifth grade level. Again, you can read it in fourth grade as well. It's a great historical fiction novel, and despite the title, there actually isn't any witch in the book. In case you were getting excited about that, sorry to disappoint you. What it is it takes place in a Puritan village in the 1600s. And the premise of the story is this woman, this young lady, who, if you remember right, her name is Kit. She leaves Barbados because her father has died, and she goes to live with her uncle, who is a Puritan in New England. And she is an Anglican, which is basically like Catholic light. You know, there's a sacramental element to her religion, and it's in many ways she's more of a kind of a ritual Christian who just kind of goes through the rituals and just does them because that's what they do, and it's more of just kind of a way of life than a deep committed belief in anything. And because she has nowhere to go, she goes to live with her uncle, who is a very devout Puritan. And it's a lot of the book is the culture clash, where she's trying to fit in, but she's all of her old ways are kind of ingrained in her. And for example, there's a scene where she's going to teach Sunday school or catechism, and she realizes the stories are just so, the lessons themselves are very boring, and she comes up with this great idea. She says, "Hey kids, why don't we act out a Bible story?" And suddenly all the little kids get all excited. They're like, "What is this? Acting out a Bible story? This is crazy." And they do it and they have a lot of fun, and suddenly the kids are learning, but in walk the authorities, and they are horrified because they view theater and acting as from the devil and demonic, and what the book doesn't say, but it was usually associated with Catholicism, because in the medieval period, when a lot of people couldn't read, the Catholic Church would actually have actors perform various plays of the Bible stories, usually with lots of humor and special effects. And so the Puritans associated theater with sinfulness because a lot of your theaters were your plays from the time, including even some Shakespeare plays, were rather naughty, and a lot of sinfulness happened, especially when you had girls being played by boys, because girls were not allowed on stage. But then they also didn't like theater because, yes, it was associated with the Catholic Church. So it's a lot of that culture clash. And what happens is there is a young lady, or actually a very, not at all young lady, an old lady who lives all by herself down by Blackbird Pond, and she's called the witch. But what it is she's not a witch, she's a Quaker. And so, but the Puritans view that as witchcraft. And so Kit ends up bonding and becoming friends with this woman. And that's the premise of it. And there's a lot of great stories, and there's a lot of, there's romance, there's some action, there's some intense scenes, and there's a trial. It sounds like just kind of a simple historical book about a girl trying to get along, but it is way more than that. You will learn all about the Puritan views. You will learn about the Quaker views. You will learn some American history. And the other thing I love is how the characters change, but not really. What it is they don't change, but your view of them changes. So you'll meet people in the beginning of the book that you don't like. And then as the book goes, you start to like those people. And then you recognize that although these people, there'll be a character who you think is just mean and hateful. And then as you get to know him better, you recognize, no, he's actually a good person, a bit humorless, but he's actually a good person and clearly has a caring heart. And then there's other people that you think are going to be the good guys. But you, as things go on, you realize that it's more of an outward appearance, and what is really going on is quite selfish. So I highly recommend it, The Witch of Blackbird Pond. It's about 200 pages. It's there's nothing that I can think of that would be viewed as immoral. It's an award winner, is on the Great Books list. I believe it won the Newbery Medal. So just, you know, the highest honor that youth fiction can get. So go pick up a copy of The Witch of Blackbird Pond if you are interested. I recommend it for boys and girls, pretty much all ages. I would even recommend it for adults. It's a book that even adults can pick up and enjoy and find compelling. The reading is great, or the prose is great, and the characters are great. They came to life. I loved it. I listened to it. The first time I heard it was listening to it on an audiobook, and I was compelled by it, or found it compelling. And then a year later, I read it in class, and one of my students, Jacob, when we stopped the book and said, okay, you got to finish that for homework. He got up and he just said, I can't wait to find out what happens, because he wanted to find out. There was a whole relationship, a romantic relationship thing that was slowly developing, and he wanted to know what was going to happen for him. And this was a kid who didn't at all seem to care about romantic relationships things, but the book set it up well enough that he was really interested. So Witch of Blackbird Pond by Elizabeth Speare, I think her name is Elizabeth George Speare, I can't remember. But, you know, Speare, Speare. All right, enjoy.